Cloud storage is essential to our daily lives. Especially for business owners, we have to make sure we have high quality file storage we can rely on. But do we put any thought into a cloud file platform before uploading files to it? You've heard of Google Drive, and I hate it. Here's why. From the moment you start attaching files to emails using Google Drive links, you start to eat up your Google account space. Each Google account has 15 gigabytes of free storage, and that storage is shared across Gmail, Google Docs, and Google Drive. I can't tell you how many times I've quickly uploaded a file to Google Drive to send to a friend or client, then I move on with my life and forget about it. That is, until my Google account storage is full, and then I'm sent a warning that I soon won't be able to receive email to my Gmail address unless I clear out storage or purchase more storage. It's a mess. But then when I go to clear out space, I'm put in this awkward spot. Do I delete these files I sent to clients? What if they try to come back at a later date and view them, and then they can't see them because poof, they're gone? At this point, you might be saying, Christian, if Google Drive is that important to you, stop complaining and pay for more storage. And you'd be right. Purchasing additional storage on Google Drive is highly affordable. 100 gigabytes will cost you $2 a month, 200 gigabytes will cost you $3 a month, and 2 terabytes will cost you $10 a month. So Google isn't exactly ripping you off for cloud storage. But I still hate Google Drive. Why? There are just better solutions out there, and so many people mindlessly pay for Google Drive and suffer through a subpar experience simply because it's convenient. I'll come out and say it. I'm obsessed with Dropbox. It's better, it'll change your life. Now the main problem with Dropbox is that you only get 2 gigabytes of storage for free, then you have to pay for 2 terabytes of storage for $12 a month. Now, that's worth it to me, but Google Drive is the obvious choice if you want to pay less for storage and have the option to only pay for 1 or 200 gigabytes of storage. Saving money on storage is great and all, but I'm sick and tired of the quirks of Google Drive. For example, when I clear out files in bulk, why does it take so long to empty the trash can? Sometimes I need to clear out files quickly to make space for more files, and I won't get more space back until the files are removed from the trash. I empty the trash and wait, and wait, and wait. Each time I refresh the page, my available storage increases a little bit, but why does it take so long? And what's the deal with the upload speed? When I've had to upload large files to Google Drive, sometimes it takes hours, even when I know my internet connection is capable of so much more. I try to upload the same exact video file to YouTube, and it uploads way faster. And the Drive web interface, it's so glitchy. Sometimes it just freezes for no reason, and I have to refresh it to get it to work. I never have these issues with Dropbox. Another pain point is Google Drive for desktop. I love the file streaming feature that allows you to access files on Google server right in your computer's file system, but the huge quirk is that although you can select which files will be downloaded for offline access, you cannot decide what files show up with the streaming. So everything that shows up on Google Drive for web is going to show up in Google Drive for desktop. And sometimes I don't want folders there. I just want them on the web version. I don't need my temp folder that's on Google Drive for web showing up on my desktop. And when I create a new Google Docs file, it's automatically added to my main Google Drive folder, which also shows on desktop. It's gross. It's just like this hyperlink to a Google Docs file, and it's stuck on my desktop. As you can see, Google Drive has quite a few pain points. I used to think nothing could beat Google Drive because it's Google. They have all the resources in the world. It wasn't until I gave Dropbox a shot that I really discovered what I was missing. And it's the little details about Dropbox that make it a better experience. You can password protect shared links to keep things confidential. You can also set expiration dates, setting a clear expectation with your client on how long they can access the file. This prevents that awkward situation on Google Drive where you're left wondering how long you should leave a file up before deleting it. And when I upload video files to Dropbox, they can be streamed instantly. With Google Drive, video files have to be processed before they can be streamed by the client. This always puts me in an awkward position. How long do I wait before emailing a link to someone? What if I've got somewhere to be and I'd rather send the link now? I've been in this position before where I send a link to a client before heading out, and I immediately get a response from them saying, I can't view the file, it's still processing. Oh, and the Dropbox app is an absolute pleasure to use. You can scan documents with your phone's camera and easily upload them to Dropbox. This eliminates apps like Cam Scanner that typically want you to pay an additional fee for the same features. The Google Drive app offers no native scanning feature. The Dropbox app offers support for dark mode. With the Google Drive app, well, you can just burn your eyes out. Now, not everything is rainbows and unicorns about Dropbox. Google Drive definitely has the superior search algorithm. I guess being the world's number one search engine has its benefits. Nothing will beat Google's accuracy with search results. Dropbox is also constantly messing with the name and pricing of their plans. I mean, one day it's Plus, and the next day it's Pro, and then the next day it's Business. What is it? I wish they would settle on pricing and storage amounts that were consistent for years to come. So is Dropbox worth it? I think at the end of the day, if you're sharing files with others, or if you're using cloud storage to sync files between multiple devices, Dropbox offers a far superior experience. This is because file sharing is Dropbox's main business. It's not an afterthought like Google Drive. But suppose you just want to back up some files and you're thinking of using Google Drive or Dropbox. I wouldn't recommend using Google Drive or Dropbox for file backup. This is because if you did have a hard drive crash, you may be left spending days trying to download hundreds or even thousands of gigabytes of files on your home internet connection. Using a proper solution like Backblaze will mean you could just get a hard drive in the mail with all of your files from the crashed drive, plug it in, copy it over, mail it back, and you're good to go. And no, Backblaze is not sponsoring this video, but shameless plug, they're amazing, link in the description below. But okay, back to use cases for Google Drive. Suppose you just need to store a lot of files securely and reliably. Google Drive can get the job done. Google Drive is also the obvious choice if you really need more storage added to your Google account for multiple reasons. It's also worth noting that you get some bonus features by paying for Google Drive storage through Google One. On some plans, Google One gives you cashback on Google Store purchases and access to a VPN on Android. But unless you're on a tight budget or really need more storage on your Google account specifically, please stop using Google Drive. So many are using it because it's convenient, but I think it's important to seek out the best platform to do the job instead of simply using what's convenient. Now, I'm always looking for independent companies that do things better than tech giants. We're always being bombarded by features and services and more products from these companies like Apple and Google. In the case of Dropbox, they just do cloud storage better than Google, and that's why I'm a happy Dropbox customer. So which cloud storage platform do you use? Do you think it's worth paying for a dedicated solution like Dropbox? I'd love to get your take in the comments below. If you like this video, hit that like button. And with that said, I'll catch you guys next time.
Accuracy be like.
Okay.